This is Valley News Live at 4.
Good afternoon and thanks for joining us. I'm Kaylee Chella. Well, hats and gloves continue to be a must as the brutal cold drags on. And unfortunately, as we approach the new year, temperatures will be dropping alongside the ball and confetti. On the First Alert Weather Day today, let's get right over to meteorologist Nathan Hopper. Nathan?
Yeah, thanks, Kaylee. Yeah, it's amazing how 0 degrees today with light wind felt okay when you think about it, and seeing some sunshine now even on our Luther Family Ford Skycam. Seeing traffic moving along there on I-29 there in South Fargo, but still seeing those snow piles piled up from the snowplow. So definitely want to keep it easy as those roads are still slippery, especially some of those intersections and some of those side roads. So cold across the board, and you see those clouds making their way across here. Maybe see a few flakes and flurries under those clouds, but by and large, nothing too impactful when it comes to active snowfall at this time. So that is the good news. But there's the temperatures. That black line you see there is the 0 degree line. So we did see some areas like Sisseton made it 14 degrees at this hour, 1 degree above zero in Fargo. But of course, Devil's Lake Basin and those counties are still sub-zero at this hour. We do expect, of course, temperatures to continue to drop right off the table along with those dangerous wind chills. Right now, say 10 to 20 below for those wind chills across our North Dakota counties. Not too bad up in Devil's Lake, though, a light wind up there. But we do have a wind chill warning from 6 p.m. tonight until noon on January 1st. So we've got 2 days, basically, of wind chill warnings of dangerous wind chills as low as 55 degrees below zero at times across these pink shaded counties. So, Kaylee, that's what we're watching is more extreme cold, but of course, we'll look ahead to the new year and what we can expect in weather-wise in a few minutes.
All right, thanks so much, Nathan. And with those 4 to 5 weather days in a row, you're going to want to keep the Valley News Live Storm Team weather app handy so you can keep up with the weather anytime, anywhere. You'll get the latest forecasts and conditions. All you got to do is search VNL Weather in the App Store. You can download it for free. Well, 3 children are now in protective custody and charges are being considered after a toddler was found outside in the cold. Someone called authorities just before 10 Tuesday morning after finding that toddler outside in the 700 block of 23rd Street South in Fargo. Fargo police say one child, who they say is about 3 years old, was found outside. 2 other children were found inside a nearby apartment. It's unknown how long that toddler was outside, and Fargo police were not able to provide information about the condition of the child, but it was 3 below zero at the time. The case has been forwarded to the Cass County State's Attorney's Office for consideration of charges. Well, that bitter cold is driving people to auto shops. Auto repair shops are surging with demand, but there are things that you can take care of at home, like an oil change and checking your tire's air pressure. You can also check your battery, filter hoses, and be sure to have an emergency kit on hand in case you get stuck somewhere. Auto shops say demand for appointments is through the roof, with one servicing 65 cars in just one day.
In the last couple of days, well, for actually the last couple of weeks, it's been very, very busy. And now with this cold snap coming in, it is very, very busy.
Car fixes can feel urgent, but the shops are also dealing with supply chain issues. So they say patience is key. 2 people are in jail following a drug bust in Red Lake, Minnesota. Police say they raided a home yesterday and found 0.5 pound of fentanyl and 2 ounces of meth alongside cash. Officers say they arrested 2 women on drug charges. Their names haven't yet been released. Fentanyl has been linked to several overdose deaths on the reservation. A Devil's Lake woman is charged with felony theft after allegedly stealing hundreds of thousands of dollars from her former employer. Court documents allege that while working at Eye Care Clinic Crein and Moen, Nancy Lee Weaver took about $350,000 in cash deposits between 2014 and 2020. Weaver was the office manager during that time and is accused of making the cash deposits into her personal account instead of the business account. The court documents also say that Weaver took that money and spent more than $400,000 at Spirit Lake Casino, losing more than $325,000 of that. An outbuilding has serious damage following a fire near Fauston, Minnesota. The Polk County Sheriff's Department says they responded to the call at a property about 3 miles north of Fauston around 8 last night. When crews arrived, they found insulation on fire inside a Quonset, which was left with some serious damage. Fortunately, no one was hurt. Authorities say the fire does not appear to be suspicious. Today, President Biden held his second call this month with Russian President Vladimir Putin. It comes amid rising tensions over Ukraine. Tens of thousands of Russian troops have gathered along Ukraine's border, stoking fears of a military invasion. And as Skylar Henry reports, the U.S. has warned of severe consequences if Russia attacks.
President Biden held Thursday's private call at the request of Russian President Vladimir Putin. At the top of the agenda, de-escalating tensions along Ukraine's border, where as many as 90,000 Russian troops are gathered.
I would assume this is an information passing event.
Former U.S. Ambassador to Ukraine William Taylor says he expects the real negotiations towards de-escalation to begin in January, when U.S. and Russian officials meet in Geneva.
Negotiations don't happen and are not going to succeed unless and until the Russians withdraw some troops and draw a lot of troops.
For weeks, the Biden administration says it's been coordinating with allies on a response to possible Russian aggression, including sanctions and an increased NATO presence, though there are no plans to deploy U.S. troops.
If he moves on Ukraine, the economic consequences for his economy are going to be devastating.
With U.S. intelligence warning Russia could attack as soon as next month, Ukrainian forces have begun training civilians to defend the country. Mr. Putin has said any Russian military action would be retaliatory, and he's demanded NATO not expand to Ukraine. Skylar Henry, CBS News, Washington.
Missing from today's call was the leader of Ukraine, who met Wednesday with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. The State Department says the two discussed efforts to peacefully resolve the conflict in eastern Ukraine. The White House says there are plans for President Biden to speak with Ukrainian President soon. As 2021 closes out, many of us are looking at year-end charitable giving. Some will take advantage of their employer's matching gifts, others give in part to generate tax deductions. But scammers are well aware of the money to be made off your generosity. AARP North Dakota says one warning sign of those is pressure to give. A legitimate charity will welcome your donation whenever you choose to make it. Other red flags include receiving a thank you for a donation you don't recall making, or a request for payment by cash, gift card, or wire transfer. The key is to do your research before you give.
You can go to give.org or charitywatch.org or charitynavigator.org, our three websites, to check. An even better way to give is to make your charitable giving decisions at the end of the year based on what you'd like to support in 2022. Write it down and stick to it. And it makes it easier to donate or decline donating by saying you've already made your giving decisions ahead of time.
If you think you might have been scammed, you can contact the AARP Fraud Watch Network hotline or go to aarp.org/fraudwatchnetwork. Well, for the second year in a row, the annual Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show will be postponed thanks to COVID-19. Organizers say the event will be held later due to the surge of Omicron in New York City. The show was originally set to take place in mid-January. A new date has not yet been announced. The dog show is usually held in February, but this year it was moved to June and held indoors because of COVID-19. It's a numbers story, and it's trending upward. COVID cases in the U.S. are at their highest level on record. And that's forcing some to rethink their New Year's Eve plans. Michael George is in Times Square, where the celebration has already been scaled back.
2021 is going out with a bang as the U.S. averages more than 277,000 new COVID cases a day and counting. Federal health officials are urging nursing home employees to get booster shots amid a spike in cases among staffers. And the CDC is advising against cruise travel, regardless of vaccination status. And as we approach New Year's Eve,
large gatherings where you're not certain of the vaccination status of people should be avoided.
Health officials say you should get tested before a gathering and a few days afterward to make sure you weren't exposed.
Our focus is vaccine and testing, vaccine and testing.
Incoming New York City Mayor Eric Adams unveiled a six-point battle plan to deal with COVID this winter.
I'm rolling out my administration plan to keep New Yorkers safe from the virus and keep our city open.
Preparations are underway here in Times Square for a scaled-down New Year's Eve celebration, limited to a vaccinated, masked crowd of 15,000 revelers.
3, 2, 1, Happy New Year!
Cruz gave the nearly 12,000-pound ball a test run Thursday.
Everything's ready to go for December 31st.
Atlanta's 32-year tradition, the Peach Drop, has been canceled again. And San Francisco scrapped plans for its fireworks show. But things may be looking up.
this thrust with Omicron over the next 6 to 8 weeks is so significant. Please, just let's get us through this one. And then I think we're going to see a light at the end of the tunnel through the rest of the year.
Something everyone could look forward to in 2022. Michael George, CBS News, New York.
We're learning that large-scale New Year's Eve celebrations have also been canceled in Paris, London, Berlin, and Israel says it will now offer a fourth vaccine dose to the most vulnerable. Look at this. A large tree weighed down with snow gave way just as they were passing by, crashed down along Interstate 5, breaking their windshield. Luckily, no one was hurt, but the tree did block traffic until a logging company could come to the rescue and move him off of the road. Work continues to build an outdoor ice rink at Target Field. The Minnesota Wild will play the St. Louis Blues in the Winter Classic there on New Year's Day. The world's largest mobile rink refrigeration unit arrived earlier this month and is a key piece in all making this work. It took 20,000 gallons of water to make the 2-inch sheet of NHL ice. The rink also actually has heaters in case that the weather is too cold. It's going to be finished today and the teams will practice on it for the first time tomorrow. Well, the Winter Classic is sold out, but fans can get in on the NHL excitement inside the Mall of America. The mall has a trophy display that includes the Stanley Cup in the mall's north atrium.
It's really cool. I've never seen it before, and me and my daughter both play hockey a lot, so we're excited to see it.
It's cool. It's like it's really big, and it's got all the names on it.
Now, the Cup is on display again today before the outdoor hockey game on Saturday. The NHL intends to play the game as scheduled, but the league is monitoring the forecast, which calls for temperatures below zero. Still to come on Valley News Live at 4. Another option just approved to do those COVID tests at home.
And of course, that frigid air does continue through Sunday morning for us tonight. Yes, we're seeing that frigid air beginning and sticking around. Sub-zero pretty much all night long for us in Fargo. Clouds may help us stay a bit more mild tonight than we could be perhaps if we didn't have cloud cover. Same for our friends in Grand Forks, about 12 below by the time we hit midnight in Grand Forks. But of course, I'll have that full forecast for you next.